Alrighty guys, so today I'm coming to you with a really quick video. It's going to be on juicing, how I make my aloe and orange juice. So if you guys want to go ahead and see how I made it, just continue watching. So I'm going to be juicing kind of sort of today, but before I get into the juicing portion, I wanted to give you a little bit of backstory. So I am filming this video because right now I think our country is consumed by all things coronavirus. It's really important to me that I maintain a healthy immune system. I know for a fact that my immune system is not the strongest, but I know personally, like, every winter I get sick. Like, I get sick at least once or twice a year with, like, the flu or the cold. Like, I know I had a flu recently that almost took me out. I have to take specific steps to make sure that I'm maintaining not only just a healthy lifestyle and a healthy body, but a healthy immune system. And I'm not showing my face because I look crazy, guys. So stick with my little polka dot nails and my little Easter decor. Zarbee's Naturals Edelberry gummies. Normally I try not to take gummies just because of like the amount of sugar in them. It's better to take things that are in capsules, but of course, you know, stores don't have anything right now. I bought this 2 weeks ago and this was the only Edelberry support that they had in the store. This has Edelberry, vitamin C, and zinc, and it's made with real Edelberry, which is good. It doesn't have any preservatives or anything like that in there, no additives. It's really just the things that are good for you. Edelberry helps promote a healthy immune system, as does vitamin C, as does zinc, and they're just really good for you. So I take one of these a day. Next up, I have vitamin D3. My mom really told me to take this. It's really good for your immune system. It supports your bones, teeth, your muscles, and your immune system. Next up, I take these Ollie multivitamins. Now, I know there are mixed reviews on them. I personally take them because I just find what works for me. And also, I haven't done the research on anything else besides Ollie. They have B12, which is good for energy production. Omega-3s, which is good for brain and heart support. Other vitamins and minerals that provide immune support, like vitamin C. Zinc has biotin, which is good for healthy hair, skin, and nails. And lastly, it's gentle on your stomach, which means that it doesn't have any like serious coats around the pill. The pill kind of looks like this. This is what the pill looks like. It might be large to some people, which I would recommend taking the gummy if it's too big for you, but I don't have any problem with taking pills. Next up, I have these aloe pills. Now, I do not take these every day. I take these like a couple days out of the week. And for me, it's just really to promote like a good gut health. And last but not least, Airborne. So I try to take vitamin C. I know taking it every day is excessive. So for me, I try to take it every couple days. Because I have these tablets that dissolve in water, I take these once a week. So today what I'm going to be making for you guys is my version of orange juice. I typically drink this every day. So you're going to need a bag of oranges. This bag comes with 8 oranges. You can get it from your grocery store. 1 lemon, ginger root. I just got one because, yeah, just need one. And 2 aloe leaves. I would assume most people can get these from their grocery store. Sometimes depending on where you live, you have to go to like a Caribbean store or like an international store to get it. So you're going to take the aloe. You don't have to wash the outside, that's excessive. I'm gonna grab my cutting board and I am just going to cut it with a knife. Now that that's cut, I'm going to go in and cut off the sides, if you guys could see. Be putting it in a ninja to blend it. This doesn't get juiced. And I just go ahead, cut this, and just cut the gel from the aloe out. And it's gonna look slimy and gross, but this is what you get. washed off my cutting board, washed my knife, and we're going to move on to the ginger. Now for the ginger, they're easy to break, so you could just like break it apart. I break mine apart so it's easier to cut off the ugly parts. Yes, I cut off the ugly parts because it's not the cutest thing. And some of the parts that I have to eat, they just look gross. Like, look at that. Who wants to eat that? Go ahead and like it, share it to a person, and I will see you guys next week.